Hello, beloved ones. Welcome, welcome to this magical unfoldment of the day. I am Matt Kahn, and it's an honor to be here with you. As we join together as one in this auspicious moment of growth, expansion, and revelation, I wanted to join you today and offer you this live transmission to offer you a way out of judgment, and more importantly, to offer you a way out of judgment from a fifth dimensional perspective. Because if we approach a way out of judgment from a 3D perspective, we tend to just loop in the law of karma. But when we take a 5D perspective, we find ourselves transcending and reversing the law of karma to create such infinitely miraculous positive benefits to pour into your life and into the hearts of all. And so in the name of our earthly ascension, in the name of manifesting and co-creating a cascading waterfall of blessings for all hearts, for Mother Earth, and to uplift the circumstances throughout your life, let us join together, heart to heart, and explore a way out of judgment. And as everyone comes on the call, hello, Martin. Matt, you look great. Thank you. I feel really great. Thank you so much. Everyone's jumping on the call. What an honor it is to be here with you. So let's talk a way out of judgment. And in order for us to explore a way out of judgment, we have to first define what a judgment is. What is a judgment? Well, I will express to you what I know judgment is from an energetic perspective. And it may be far different than how we used to, or we tend to think about judgment. Because of course, from an empathic perspective, we think of judgment as someone's unprocessed pain. We think of it as a trauma response. And these things are not untrue. But the question remains, what allows someone to live in trauma response? And what causes a person to live in a pain that remains unprocessed? And from an energetic perspective, we glean even higher insights that help us to expand the horizons of what we know a judgment to be. So from an energetic perspective, what is a judgment? A judgment is a cluster of fermented, unexpressed prayers and blessings that live in someone's heart, that when not utilized as intentions, prayers, and blessings on a regular basis, that reservoir of energy ferments and becomes either the energy of retaliation that we turn onto ourselves or project onto other people. And so in the third dimension, it's a very wildly popular campaign to stop judging. There are infinite processes that promise this is what's going to stop your judgments. But from a fifth dimensional perspective, we don't stop what has already started. If we are attempting to end what has begun, we are then the adversarial force to that energy. We then become the unconsciousness to unconsciousness, or the darkness to darkness. We are not darkness as darkness. We are the light of consciousness. So even though it can seem very alluring to want to stop judgment so that you can treat yourself nicer, so you can be more conscious and kind to other people, we can get to that endpoint. We can get to that effect. But how we take the journey is what matters most. And if we know judgment to be clusters of fermented, unexpressed intentions, blessings, and prayers that haven't been expressed from someone's heart, then that means the ability to learn how to set intentions, send out blessings, and take time for prayer as often throughout the day as judgments arise is what allows that fermented energy to be circulated with consciousness, which allows the energy of potential judgment to be embraced, cultivated, and utilized as intentions, prayers, and blessings that we set out into the world. And from a higher quantum perspective, we respect and honor the souls of every human being around us who may be enduring trials and tribulations, that while in their healing journey, they are learning in their current curriculum about the faith of the universe by being the recipient of the prayers and blessings that others around them send for their well-being. Equally so, as the senders of intentions, prayers, and blessings, we are learning of the power of our consciousness, and we are learning to be grateful and thankful to every person we see in need, because they are equally helping to free every human being of judgment, just as soon as each human being gets onto the fact that judgment is what naturally occurs from an unconscious perspective when the intentions, blessings, and prayers that fill your heart on a daily basis go unexpressed for your benefit or the benefit of others. So what is it like to realize that the people in your life around you are enduring what they're going through as a part of their unique sovereign journey, but that the reason you are witnessing the unfoldment of their journey is because the support you can offer them verbally, emotionally, and energetically is allowing more of the energy that's in your heart to be given to support others? And of course, through the law of one, how we support others is equally of support of ourselves. And as we utilize the power of intention, prayer, and blessings on a daily basis, there remains no energy left to ferment into unexpressed blessings, intentions, and prayers, which means no judgments in your heart to avoid, watch, witness, or overcome. So which feels like an easier, more direct journey? Constantly staring into the inner depths of your being, or watching your mind and scanning and watching and patrolling for a judgment to avoid, to fight and overcome? Or simply remembering that judgments are just fermented, unexpressed intentions, prayers, and blessings? And the more often each day we express intentions, prayers, and blessings, whether towards ourselves or other people, the more we are moving the energy in our heart. And as long as we're moving the energy of our heart, it doesn't stagnate, it doesn't calcify, and become the very unconscious energy that we use to harm ourselves or others. And as I'm just going to look at the comments really quick. Looks like everyone's really resonating with us. So let's take it a step deeper. Let's make this interactive. Try this as a repeat after me, and then we'll go further in the interactive nature of this transmission. I accept I can move beyond judgment without having anything to defeat. I accept that my way out of judgment is remembering that the nature of judgment is fermented, unexpressed intentions, prayers, and blessings. That as I allow them to be expressed on a daily basis, whether for my benefit or for others, it helps me not only to support others in my life, to further the ascension of humanity. But to empty the reservoir of energy in my heart. So that there is no judgment for me to avoid, fight, or psychoanalyze. If it is my aim to stop judgment, I can only do so by allowing new intentions, prayers, and blessings to begin. For in the fifth dimension, as I create new patterns of higher vibrational expression, each intention, prayer, and blessing, acting as a vote I cast toward living in a higher dimension. The more often I intend, pray, and bless, the less and less judgment there is to resolve. And I equally accept that any time I'm judged by another person, it is their soul begging for my blessing and prayers. Whether I have the strength to say it to them directly or in the aftermath of conflict. For any tendency to be judged is reminding me who in life needs more blessings of source. Where the pain I endure from their judgment is a direct I am experience of the pain they have yet to process. And equally so, anytime a judgment arises in my mind, whether it's my creation, or more likely, judgments I'm empathing and clearing from the collective, I will stop in that moment. Intend, pray, and bless for humanity at large. Honoring the wisdom of judgment that arises only to remind me when to use the energy of my heart instead of allowing it to ferment and fester within me. For in the heart of judgment, beyond the first memory of trauma you can remember, is the tormented energy of intentions, prayers, and blessings. That have yet to be expressed. I know this is a long repeat after me, but this is a good one. So let's continue to repeat after me. So what if the nature of judgment is not rooted in an initial trauma? But the torment of the power within me that begs to be expressed And when the power of light within me is not expressed, that power thinks it's in survival mode. And it asks, who do I have to defeat? Within this body or outside this body? To allow my will of transformation to be expressed. Which means I am the liberator of my inner power. I end its conflict by letting it out to play. A play where it will transform the circumstances of myself and others. As often as I intend, pray, and bless for myself and all. I allow all judgments of judgment to be released. And I embrace the truth of judgment. That reminds me how often to intend, pray, and bless as a way of uplifting the world and resolving inner conflict. As I thank the state of the world for being embroiled in so much pain that there are far more things to bless and pray for. Than time to criticize, condemn, and judge. I make peace with judgment. As a reminder of when me or the world, or when I and the world need the power of my intentions, prayers, and blessings the most. And so I'm free. Feel that. Incredibly profound. We are beginning 2023, and as I have been serving you all faithfully for 18 years, that will continue at an even higher level, where my intention for you all that I serve is that this is the year that you will experience liberation, renewal, and freedom on an entirely new level. And we begin by completely reframing and redefining what judgment is, because there is a way out of judgment. It's just not going to occur by you fighting with it. It's not going to occur by you saying, stop judging. It's not going to occur by trying to correct other people. It occurs by learning that judgment acts as a request for blessings from Source. And because we are all beings of divinity, when someone judges you, their emotional gas tank is empty, and they're begging for a drop of grace. If I'm in public and someone says, get the hell out of my way, I absolutely will, and may you be blessed. And I don't even mind if they look back and smile or not. I'm just grateful that they said what they said to remind me of what they need, so I could step into action for them, for the world, for all. And if I were to tell you that judgments don't arise in my mind, I'm not saying it as this lofty claim. I'm saying it because I have undergone a transformation that you are in the midst of, in which you learn to intend, pray, and bless so often that judgment has nothing to remind you of. In the beginning of your journey, you need judgment to remind to interrupt the ego like a pattern interrupt, to give you a chance to commune with your soul. But the true intention of a spiritual journey is not to spend time dissecting your ego. It's to spend more time getting to know your soul, because your soul is who the ego becomes when it grows up. And if you spend more time with your grown-up integrated ego or your soul, that moves you from one act of your life's movie into a higher act of your life's movie, where you can live as the integrated maturity of your soul instead of spiraling in spiritual childhood through the law of karma. So let's try this together. I intend to be the space the universe works through. To deliver light to humanity that fills and heals all aspects of myself. As I bless all that I am as a being of divinity. As I pray for opportunities to bring more of my light into action for the well-being of all. To the best of my ability, I intend to be the grace, either present or absent from any interaction. To bless others with wholeness and harmony, whether in response to their politeness or disrespectful behavior. And it doesn't mean I have to stay in a situation where I'm disrespected. If I need to remove myself, I will bless them as I leave. And when and if judgments arise in me, may I ask Source to bless me with all that I need. To step more into the adulthood of soul. As a way of integrating the existential childhood of ego. And if I start my day with this intention, or an intention that I come up with in the moment, if I send blessings to the world throughout my day, and respond with prayer to any global atrocity, if direct action is unable to be taken, the more often I intend, bless, and pray, the less ego there is to battle, the less judgment there is to defeat. where I honor the wisdom of judgment. As it reminds me of the opportunities to commune with my soul. Instead of play with my ego. Which is always a game. Where everyone loses. Just feel for a moment. Take this moment and in the comments if you can. Write a few words to describe how you're feeling in this transmission. How is this revelation of judgment? How is this new approach of looking at it from a 5D perspective and the energy that you feel me transmitting right now through these words and through my gaze? How is this feeling for you? Rebecca's feeling free. Annis, I needed to hear this. Kiefer, and so it is. Nancy, a book would be great on this. Thank you. I've thought of it. Relaxed and empowered. I love this. Those are two words to express. Martin, I feel wiped. Good. Sandy, very light. Hopeful. Feeling more expansion, spacious. Jeff, I'm crying. Thank you, brother. I cry with you. Lots of tears. Settling in ease. Calming. Kate, in deep grief right now. I need to be more patient with myself. Kate, we love you. How about this, Kate? While you're learning to be patient with yourself, we will be the patience that you're still cultivating. Can I be your patience? Can I be patient for you? Can I help you? And for everyone on this call that needs patience. And let me make a bold claim. It is never impatience that causes you to judge. That's a third dimensional interpretation. Impatience doesn't lead to judgment. Impatience is a phenomenon of how often we ferment our heart energy instead of express it as intentions, prayers, and blessings. When you express intentions, prayers, and blessings every day, you are already rooted in patience, which decreases the likelihood of judgment arising. So let us be more patient with ourselves and others. Would it be so outrageous to say that there are some people that are in such a state of duress and conflict that they're screaming out for help, but it sounds more like an attack than a cry for help? Like a dog barking in pain that you're perceiving as, I think this dog is angry with me. Now, of course, it's important to learn the language of a dog's tail and to understand whether this is a dog in pain needing help or being territorial. But isn't it interesting, as human beings, we can interpret everyone's anger as being territorial when it's actually a cry for help? And the more often we intend, pray, and bless for ourselves and the world, the less afraid of people we become. And I say this to you as someone who has been afraid of every human being I've ever met and afraid of every single thing my entire life up until many years ago when this all started for me. So I'm not speaking to you from a perspective that is unaware. I'm very aware of what it's like to be afraid of every single person I know. I'm very aware of what it's like to feel as if someone's going to jump out of the bushes and attack you. And that festered in a heart that had so many intentions, prayers, and blessings to send out. And I didn't know the signal. I didn't know how to do it. So let me share with you the easiest way to set an intention, blessing, and prayer, so that we can start turning this around. And we can start living in the fifth dimension that is already here. But let me be clear in saying the fifth dimension is already here, but on a collective level, it is still existing in a state of essence, moving towards presence. That's what ascension is. 5D is already here, but its potential not reality for most people. So we have to move it from essence to presence. We have to move it from potential to reality. And how do we do that? By exchanging judgments for intentions, prayers, and blessings. That is alchemy. So let me quickly teach you about intention. Intention is not about intending an outcome. That's a hope, and that's beautiful, but that's not an intention. An intention is, what is the adjective of emotional energy that I intend or desire for other people to experience in my presence? Equally so, it's the same emotional experience you wish, intend to experience in other people's presence, no matter their behavior. So if I said to you, I intend to embody love and to experience love no matter how others appear or act around me. That is setting the intention that you wish to take the energy in your heart, and instead of allowing it to ferment, you allow all the material of that heart energy to be molded into the vibration of love and radiated out into everyone you encounter and reflected back to you no matter what level of consciousness anyone operates at. And you just said it once in the morning. I intend to be the embodiment of love, or whatever adjective you choose, and to radiate that love and to experience that love in every encounter now. It's not an intention that's telling your ego you have to achieve this. It's, I intend to allow the universe to enact this greater intention, and I will be the space in which it moves through. That's an intention. When you're in the presence or in the aftermath of conflict and someone wasn't being their nicest, highest self, we say that's someone who needs blessings. And so we take the time to say, dear beloved universe, please bless the life of so-and-so to bring them into their highest harmony, highest light, and highest self. So we learn to bless others with all that they need to step into their highest self in response to any derogatory behavior, while of course not being people's emotional doormats along the way. And prayers are what we send out in response to tragic news from a loved one, something happening in your community, or a news headline you see on the internet. If you see something disturbing, hear about something disturbing, I pray for the highest resolution in this matter, and may my light help move it forward towards that highest, greatest good. You see, we're intending positive outcome, we're doing it from a state of detachment, and we're allowing all the energy in our heart to be used and expressed as fifth dimensional intentions, prayers, and blessings, instead of fermenting and becoming the very conflict that you will then use other spiritual processes to try to dissect, deconstruct, and resolve. But that's only when you're trying to stop a judgment, which we've learned today, you don't stop judgments. You only have intentions, blessings, and prayers to start. And as you begin voting for the fifth dimension, as often throughout the day, as judgments either come towards you or judgments arise within you, each time is giving you a chance to vote for 5D vibrations. And every time an intention, prayer, and blessing is sent to others or yourself, you are continually voting to vote yourself into and to vote the collective into living in the fifth dimension, which already exists in essence and is moving into presence, is moving from potential into reality, which is the cosmic multidimensional alchemy we are experiencing as the manifestation of heaven on earth, known as ascension. George says, I feel nauseous. That means energy in your sacral chakra is being released. So just say to your sacral chakra in your stomach, thank you, sacral chakra, for releasing all the energy that I'm healing right now. And thank you for sharing that, George. Kevin Riley, he's always fantastic, ain't he? Well, thank you. I love being fantastic for you. I love rising to the occasion for you. I love being phenomenal for you because you deserve the highest and the holiest. And any capacity of power within me, I am madly in love with sharing with you. I love this work we do together. I love being a part of your life. And I thank you for the honor of being a part of it. And if you have felt the depth of transformation in redefining judgment, I invite you all to join me this Thursday evening for a live group healing event called Together as One, where the theme of the event will be ending self-sabotage. So if you can feel how powerful this call has been or this transmission has been for judgment, you can only imagine how powerful the transmission will be this Thursday night when I will guide you through ending self-sabotage. Because when I set an intention that I'm going to help you be more liberated and free this year than ever before, it's a reality I bring to you. And no matter what time zone you're in, if you purchase a ticket for the live event, you get a free replay of infinite replays so that everyone in every time zone can enjoy this. And you'll have a chance to ask questions live. There'll be interactive processes, and we will literally channel this event out of thin air live together. And I'll bring you the most compelling fifth dimensional way to end self-sabotage that will complement the work we're doing right now in giving you a way out of judgment. I think I've pinned a comment on this video which has a direct link to register for this event. Please go to mattkahn.org and sign up for Together as One, the end of self-sabotage, this Thursday evening. James says, this is resourceful. Thank you. Unconditional love from Rebecca. Kiefer, I trust in the consciousness. I love all this. Marianne, hey, wow. This is just the beginning. This is 2023. We made it through the vision quest. This is where we put all the pieces together. The last few years have been really rough. I've been with you every step of the way. And now it is my time to step further into service and higher into leadership. And I'm doing so because it's time for us all to step into higher service and leadership. And so may we all come together in this transmission, this Thursday for Together as One, and every moment throughout. May we step together, step forward into higher levels of service and leadership for the evolution of our journey and for the transformation of our world. Because our world needs new empathic, trauma-informed, heart-centered leaders. And our time has come. Time to lead. Not to lead followers, but to be the leaders that ignite the spark of leadership in the hearts of all beings. I look forward to seeing you this Thursday for Together as One. Please register at mattkahn.org. And thank you for enjoying and receiving this way out of judgment. I'm so excited to help you end self-sabotage once and for all. All my love to you. Namaste.